I'm Umang, a PhD student at University of Southern California, and I'll be discussing our work on membership inference attacks on deep regression models for neuroimaging. Most machine learning models require huge amount of data for training. Thus, this often requires aggregating data across various sources to a centralized server or a centralized location to train the final model. However, data privacy laws restrict sharing or aggregation of data across sources. To alleviate this problem, federated learning has been proposed. Federated learning enables learning by sharing models trained on local data rather than the data itself. Essentially, federated learning works around the data sharing restriction by sharing models. However, model sharing itself can reveal private information. In this work, we ask this very question. Can an adversary extract information from given only the models and some easily accessible knowledge of data distribution? In particular, we replicate a form of privacy leakage revealed by membership inference attacks on neuroimaging data. Membership inference attack involve inferring if a sample belongs to a training set or not. While the knowledge that a sample was used for training the model or not is in itself harmless. However, coupled with some more auxiliary information, this can reveal confidential information in the hands of an adversary. For example, if the adversary had the knowledge that a particular training set was consisting of subjects that had a particular illness, then the adversary can claim with some confidence that the sample that it has might be suffering from that illness. To demonstrate a successful membership inference attack, we consider models trained to predict brain age from UK Biobank MRI scan. We consider or replicate the centralized training setup as well as federated training setup from the recent works. We demonstrate the membership inference attack for two different architectures. We assume that the adversary has access to the model parameters as well as training data or training data distribution. The access to training data distribution or the feasibility of access to training data or training data distribution is further discussed in our paper. The adversary can thus train a classifier to predict the membership of a sample using the features derived from the model and sample. To judge the severity of privacy leakage, we report the accuracy of membership inference attack. The higher the accuracy, the more severe is the privacy leakage. Coming to the results, the table here shows the attack accuracy under different data access assumptions. When the adversary has more lenient access to data, for example, when the adversary has access to training samples or some part of the training data itself, the attack accuracies tend to be higher and can go up to 83% for 2D slice CNN. Whereas if the adversary has access only to training distribution, the attack accuracies or the privacy leakage drops to 74%. The bottom row shows the distribution for different features used by adversary to do membership inference. We can clearly see that the training and test distribution are different, thus making this a very effective features for inferring the membership of the sample. We consider different scenarios in case of federated training. We consider the setup for the attacks. We consider the setup where one of the learner tries to attack the global model. Thus, the assumption that the attacker has access to the training data is trivially valid. We deferred the detailed discussion of results with federated training to our paper. However, we make one interesting remark from our results. We find that as the number of federation rounds increase, the attack accuracy or the privacy leakage increases, which reveals a trade-off between learning and privacy leakage. Ideally, one would like to train for more federation rounds to learn a better model. However, it also leads to more privacy leakage. We further investigate this phenomena by training models specifically to mitigate privacy leakage up to different extent. We find that the attack accuracy, which is shown on y-axis, is highly correlated with overfitting, which is shown on x-axis. The overfitting here is measured as the difference between training and test error. We see that as the model overfits more, the attack accuracy increases, thus indicating the higher attack accuracy may be due to the tendency of neural networks to memorize the training sample. The privacy learning trade-off is much better revealed by by looking at this plot. We can see the attack accuracy on the y-axis and mean absolute error on the x-axis. We can see that the attack accuracy can be reduced to near random, that is 50%. However, the model suffers, or however, the model performance suffers drastically and falls from less than 3.0 to more than 4.0 in terms of mean absolute error. To conclude, we demonstrated that not only sharing data, but sharing models also can reveal private information about the participants. We demonstrate successful membership inference attacks under centralized as well as federated setup and under varying learning scenarios. Finally, we observe a strong correlation between the attack accuracy and the overfitting. Efforts to mitigate this this privacy leakage can also lead to models with better generalization capabilities. Thank you.